Before I start this video, I just want to preface that for whosoever has been a part of this channel and seen its journey, you know that I made a consistent effort in showcasing the problematic themes of Indian cinema that has not only objectified women but has blurred the lines when it comes to the concept of consent and what can be considered to be acceptable with respect to relationships, boundaries, and a glorification of regressive customs. What I just want to reiterate is that the topics that I'm going to focus on today are not seen in a vacuum. I acknowledge that the problems with respect to the role of women and relationships is still ongoing, but wanted to shed light on an aspect barely spoken about in mainstream media. Two things have happened this week which made me think about possibly topics that we generally tend to ignore. The incident in Lucknow where a woman slapped a taxi driver incessantly, and one of my favorite YouTube channels, Pop Culture Detective, released a video about men, vulnerability, and what and when society has expected the appropriate window for the gender to be vulnerable and cry. These two events made me think about questions such as what really makes a man, as in what have we been conditioned to believe, the problematic tropes that exist with respect to the portrayal of the LGBTQI community, and finally, what is the reason why we have treated and showcased crimes against men, especially in films and TV shows, with a light-hearted and comedic lens. I think what is brilliant about the recent video by Pop Culture Detective is that it resonates with many men, as it showcases the social conditioning of the sex and the toxic relationship that they have with vulnerability. We see this same social conditioning to be applicable for the portrayal of men and moments of pure emotion in movies and TV shows, where situations have to be extremely grave and monumental for characters to simply break down. And if the predicament in any way is considered to be not life-altering, then any sadness or vulnerability is equated to weakness. What the video successfully sheds light on, and this is something that I deeply connected with, is that there is a sense of shame that comes with being emotional with another person. The reason why Srikanth Tiwari on a phone call with Suchi holds himself back, a moment where he wanted nothing but to simply break down, is because it is expected of him to be strong all the time. The reason why Ved in Tamasha looks at himself in the mirror and gives himself two options to either run free like Majnu or put a facade on to appear as if everything is fine is because we have been conditioned all our life to keep moving forward. The concept of pausing, letting oneself go, or breaking down is all equated to weakness. The reason why the phone call conversation between Karan Shergill and his father in Laksh impacts audiences so much is because there exists such a rarity of emotional moments between the male genders. We have, at least for the majority of the case, experienced a hardened exterior with our fathers, a barrier tough to go past. Something that is reminiscent of Ronit Roy's fictional characters in Hindi films that make men believe that this is the norm and subsequently makes us emotionally stagnant. This reminded me of the polarizing advertisement that had come out from Vogue India and the catchphrase "Ladke rote nahi hai," a saying that possibly everyone has heard while growing up. It is probably as common as the flippant remark given to women of the fact that they play like a girl. I mean, after the current Olympics and the performances of women, I would say that statement as nothing but a compliment. Irrespective, many people connected with the advertisement because it highlights the social conditioning of men not to be vulnerable, even for monumental moments at different stages of life. But that advertisement rubbed people the wrong way, especially because it equated how the toxic nature of bringing up men leads to them projecting by showcasing violence to the opposite sex. Something that came across as a strawman argument to me. How many experiences actually shape up an individual is rather forgotten, and what the advertisement adopted was this simplistic and rather ignorant equation that one leads to the next. It reminded me of how everyone equates any kind of violence in society to either video games or films, but not really trying to research what may be the experiences of the individual while growing up. The specific case of Lucknow made me think about the horrible nature with which we have dealt with crimes against men in fictional storylines. An expectation exists for the particular sex to figure things out and be strong enough to persevere from adversity. A point brought up by Pop Culture Detective's YouTube channel is actually very thought-provoking. The toxic conditioning is prevalent in men so much when you think about the Me Too story of Terry Crews, where he was mocked when he came out about a producer taking advantage of him. people equating his size and considering it laughable that someone would cross the line with him. Or the double standard that exists when male minors are sexually assaulted by adult females. Men themselves in the grapevine disgustingly state how the young kids are lucky because they got with such a hot teacher. The toxic nature is so indoctrinated that even men can't highlight and understand the severity of certain cases because it is expected of them not to be victims. I can list down several examples across cinema that have not only made fun of physical crimes against men, but in the process has portrayed the LGBTQI community in the most predatory and sick fashion. A movie directed by Rahul Ravel that is painful to witness is the 1991 movie titled Mast Kalandar. This is the time the film industry really went downhill. Middle-aged or older actors saying yes to mediocre and over-the-top scripts just to be actively working. Considered to be the first portrayal of a gay character in Hindi cinema, Anupam Kher as Pinku does not care about consent and constantly harasses other characters. Orange hair, over-the-top antics, calling everyone sexy and cute, the stereotypical way the older generation believes gay people are. But the exterior is one thing. The lack of consent in every physical interaction that Pinku has is more alarming, as it is always showcased with a comedic background music.
ये हाथ दोबारा जेब में रख दो, बटवे के अलावा और पैसे दूंगा।
You look at Akshay Kumar's cameo in the 2016 action comedy Dishoom. He plays the role of Sameer Ghazi, the most stereotypical over-the-top and flamboyant gay party animal. Surrounded by ripped men and underwears, desperately wanting some kind of sexual pleasure, it will make you nothing but cringe. But the problem beyond the portrayal of a gay character is that he makes others strip, addresses Dhawan as his little boy, ogles at them while they undress, touches one of them inappropriately and says karne dena, and all of this while Subha Hone Na De plays in the background, telling you again that this isn't as serious as you may think. In the 2007 film Partner, Suresh Menon plays the role of Kiran, the heroine's best friend. Flailing arms, over-the-top fashion, messes up his own gender pronouns and consistently gets more and more aroused as Govinda caresses his shoulder. Commercial comedies aside, the 2000s also presented the rise of sex comedies, films that did exponential business in the box office. In the 2012 film Kya Super Cool Hai Hum, a gay character gets an erection mid-conversation assuming that the other character is gay. Feeling violated and taken advantage of, the act is passed off as comedy.
साले की खुशी चेहरे पे कम, पैंट पे ज़्यादा दिखाई दे रही थी।
In the 2016 film Masti Zade, a gay character is named Sondas and introduced as Jab Dekho Hilate Rehta Hai, a character sporting a pink lily as a headpiece that constantly moans and speaks about objects with sexual innuendos. Similarly, in the 2017 film Badrinath Ki Dulhania, Vaidehi and Badri are presumably surrounded by thugs, and when they corner Badri rather than mugging him, they take advantage of him, copping a feel everywhere. And all of this is a comedic gag, by the way. So much so that when the characters even come to Badri's rescue, rather than consoling him, they laugh at the situation. Every single time, somehow, in these fictional storylines, a gay character is portrayed as a man who is desperate for any sexual arousal and does not care about one's consent in a physical instance. You look at Akshay Kumar in Kambhakt Ish being forcefully, anally probed by a black woman. Being thrown around while he constantly yells and says no is all showcased as a comedic gag. I had recently also spoken about Govinda's Raja Bhaiya. A character that is extremely naive and innocent is constantly taken advantage of by two women with the worst American accents you can think of. When requested to push their car, just see this scene and imagine how problematic the sequence would have been if the sexes were reversed. This carries on throughout the film, where the two women constantly chase the hero, do perverse acts to their heart's content, and laugh it off while the hero is visibly uncomfortable. But it's comedy, right? It does lead to the debate that in the pursuit of equality, we can't possibly have a double standard when it comes to physical crimes against men, even if they are fictional stories. I think the situation we are at is an extremely complex one and an amalgamation of several aspects that shape us as individuals. While I do take out the time to highlight the several issues we have as a constantly evolving society, but still very sexist and patriarchal in our way, these are important aspects of life that are often ignored by mainstream media and should not be dismissed as non-issues. And that was the video, guys. Write down in the comments below what you thought about this topic. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle's right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.